From Montana's news leader, this is the MTN 9 o'clock news.
Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Russ Reisinger. Montana's newly elected lawmakers converge in Helena to choose their leaders for the upcoming session. And majority Republicans say they're excited about their first chance in 16 years to work in tandem with a Republican governor. But the meetings at the Capitol today were not without some controversy. The MTN chief political reporter Mike Dennison has the story.
As Republicans chose their 2021 legislative leaders Wednesday, the new Senate Majority Leader, Kerry Smith of Billings, expressed the optimism and excitement that many of them felt.
I am so excited about this legislative session. This is the first opportunity many of us have to work with a Republican governor. It's up to us. We hold all the offices. We hold the leadership. We hold the majorities. And so it's up to us now, as the people of Montana have sent us here, to take and get some good work done.
And the new Speaker of the Montana House, rancher and State Representative Wiley Gault of Martinsdale, said the GOP majorities are ready to carry out the priorities of incoming Republican Governor Greg Gianforte.
We're going to be a united front. We have a Republican governor that we're going to rally behind, and I think the Republican Party is going to move as a block this session.
Republicans have a 67-33 majority in the House and a 31-19 majority in the state Senate. Senator Mark Blaisdell of Kalispell was chosen as the Republican president of the Senate, and House Republicans chose Billings Representative Sue Vinton as majority leader, the first female Republican House majority leader in Montana history. Democrats said they'll try to work with Republicans on many issues, but they weren't happy with how most GOP members completely ignored public health protocols at their Capitol meetings. In both the House and Senate Republican caucuses held on the Senate and House floors, almost no members wore face masks, which are required of the public in the Capitol. And social distancing seemed largely non-existent as GOP members shook hands and frequently spoke with each other, maskless, in close proximity. On Wednesday, Montana saw more than 1,200 new cases of COVID-19 reported, continuing a huge surge in recent weeks of the spread of the coronavirus across the state. House Minority Leader Kim Abbott of Helena said Democrats won't be participating if such actions continue by GOP members at the Capitol.
Is what I saw on video of the House chambers today was reckless. And we cannot participate in that kind of recklessness.
Representative Gault said he's willing to talk to Abbott and Democrats about their concerns, but that he may not be able to stop GOP members from doing what they choose to do on the floor or perhaps elsewhere.
I can suggest, but we cannot stop anyone for any reason going onto the House floor and doing what the state elected them to do.
Republicans hold all the political cards in driving the agenda at the 2021 session. But now the hard work begins, deciding just what a session will look like in the midst of a pandemic. Reporting from Helena, Mike Dennison, MTN News.
The session is scheduled to convene in Helena on January 4th. Well, county health authorities across Montana confirming 10 more COVID-19 related deaths today. That's a total of 29 reported in just the last 2 days. Two of the victims from Yellowstone County, one of those a man in his 30s. MTN reports the total deaths across Montana has now reached 582. Tonight there were 1,232 cases are today reported as well. And there are now nearly 18,000 confirmed active cases across the state. There's been some positive news lately when it comes to a possible vaccine for COVID-19. And one of Montana's U.S. senators is taking part in one of the trials. MTN's Gabby Krevet has more.
On Wednesday afternoon, U.S. Senator Steve Daines announced he was one of many Montanans participating in Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine trial. This comes just days after Pfizer's announcement of the vaccine being 95% effective. And Senator Daines says he's tested positive for COVID-19 antibodies. Senator Daines says it was his mother who encouraged him to join Pfizer's vaccine trial taking place in Bozeman.
My wife and I decided to go online and enroll in the trial, and we joined over 100 Montanans, many from the area there in southwest Montana, who were participating in that particular trial.
The trial is blind, meaning the senator and other participants were not told if they received the vaccine or a placebo.
I have since tested positive for the COVID-19 antibodies, which likely means I actually got the actual vaccine.
Daines testing positive for antibodies could mean he's protected against COVID-19 if exposed to the virus. Daines said he chose to participate in the trial to help Montanans build confidence and trust in a vaccine. Daines also added, while highly encouraged, vaccines shouldn't be mandated.
While I do believe that a vaccine is key to getting back to normal, I don't believe in mandating it. I would, however, encourage Montanans to get the vaccine once it's approved, in consultation, of course, with their doctor.
Reporting in Bozeman, Gabby Crevett, MTN News.
Well, fans hoping for relaxed spectator restrictions for Friday night's state AA football championship are out of luck. Billings School District 2 Activities Director Mark Wall confirms to Q2 that the district will only allow 2 tickets per title game participant. It's the same policy that School District 2 has had in place for every game in Yellowstone County this season. Health officers approved a larger plan of 6 tickets per player and 4 per coach, but School District 2 has consistently stayed at the MHSA's minimum number for safety reasons. Each player, coach, and cheerleader for both West and Missoula Sentinel must submit 2 names to be checked at the entrance gate. There will be no pep bands or student sections allowed. Kickoff set for 7 o'clock Friday night at Dayless Stadium in Billings, and those who can't attend in person can watch online on the NFHS network, and it does cost a fee. After nearly 8 years in the making, the state of Montana ruled that contaminated coal ash from retired Colstrip power plants 1 and 2 will be dug up and hauled away to a high, dry, environmentally safe location. Environmental groups are pleased with Tuesday's ruling from the Department of Environmental Quality. They see the decision as an immediate job creator, resulting in as many as 150 high-paying jobs for years to come. However, the timing of Tuesday's ruling may leave the final decision on the coal ash cleanup up to the new administration of Governor-elect Greg Gianforte. The leaking contaminants are harmful to humans, livestock, and wildlife. The DEQ decision calls for the full excavation of the 330-acre site and relocating the ash to a new lined impoundment above the water table. The cost, an estimated $285 million, to be paid up front by Colstrip operator Talon Energy. A Talon spokesperson says the company has not decided if it will appeal the state's decision, but has 30 days to do so. Oil industry layoffs across eastern Montana and western North Dakota now represent more than 20% of that sector's workforce in the region. The North Dakota Department of Mineral Resources warns even more jobs are at risk as unpredictable oil prices and a worsening pandemic keep the lid on the number of operating oil rigs and crews. Department Director Lynn Helms points to 11,700 unemployment claims filed with the state as of November 7th, directly connected to cutbacks across the Bakken oil fields. Now, this past week, only 6 completion crews were at work in North Dakota. Much of their work is cleanup and capping of abandoned wells funded by the CARES Act. The number of active oil rigs held steady over the past month at 14. But even with those 14 rigs, the number of working oil rigs in North Dakota is down a whopping 80% from this past January. Well, Billings Logan International Airport is expecting an uptick in travelers this coming Thanksgiving week. Director of Aviation Kevin Plone says that's good news for the industry.
Like on Tuesday and Wednesday of next week, we could be pushing close to 1,000 passengers each day. Typically, we've had some Thanksgivings where we've hit close to 2,000 passengers, but, you know, given how everything else has been this year, we'll take 1,000 passengers in a day any day. Most people have been traveling by car lately, and sometimes when you travel by car, you're not so worried about what's in your suitcase or in your travel bag. There's been a substantial number of guns being detected at screening points because people forgot that they went someplace and didn't pull their guns out. That's a no-no in the airport world.
Plone says if you haven't flown in a while, most of the same rules apply. There's a few reminders, of course, wear your mask and socially distance while in the terminal. Any food that you're carrying on board should be in a see-through Ziploc bag. Leave yourself at least 90 minutes before your flight to get through security and get to your gate. The airport is undergoing construction. There are new security scanners that do take a little longer, and those scanners are in use at Billings Logan and Bozeman Yellowstone airports. It's a new baggage check technology to reduce contact points amid the pandemic. The machines were installed in mid-October and are 2 of the 300 being used across the country. It's a new type of X-ray scan called computed tomography. It creates a 3D image of the contents of each traveler's luggage. This decreases the chance of a traveler needing a bag search because of the TSA agents can see the contents more clearly. Well, the holiday season is quickly approaching, but some small toy stores are worried this one could be their last. MTN's Kaylee Neitzel spoke with some Great Falls toy shops to see how they've been affected.
This time of year, many people are going about their holiday shopping. But this year, with the coronavirus pandemic, shopping trends are shifting. And small businesses that typically do well during these months, like toy stores, are beginning to feel the struggle of this change.
So this time it's kind of slow. Today started off nice, but like all retail, it's hard to tell.
Small toy shop owners say it's become even more difficult to compete with online retailers like Amazon and big box stores like Target and Walmart. They say the pandemic also caused issues because their small spaces make it difficult to practice social distancing guidelines. These stores are also experiencing difficulties with getting new inventory, as the warehouses they order from are operating with reduced staff.
So tough to gauge on when stuff will be here. Sometimes it takes 6 months to get something, and it's hard.
A national survey of independent toy store and gift boutique owners found that 64% of these business owners did not believe they would make it through to next year.
The store owners that I spoke with today would also like to remind everyone to shop local this holiday season, as it could make all the difference in helping some small businesses survive this time. In Great Falls, I'm Kaylee Neitzel, MTN News.
And some good news about Turkey Tuesday, which took place yesterday at the Q2 studios. Our community donating 2,090 turkeys, 5,200 pounds of non-perishable food, and nearly $46,000 in cash to the Billings Food Bank. You also dropped off 8 boxes of toys, 5 bikes, more than $500 in cash for Toys for Tots. So well done, Billings and Yellowstone County. You're certainly stepping up to help others celebrate the holidays. We certainly appreciate that. Still ahead on the MTN 9 o'clock news on the CW, it's almost time to pack up the truck, hit the slopes. I'm going to tell you what to expect on Red Lodge Mountain this winter. But first, there's no snow on the way for Billings. Bob will tell you what we can expect in your full 7-day forecast.